Previously on Castaway Survivors. Matt and his mates headed out to the remote Snapper Island, but when the boat was not properly secured, they became stranded. As castaways on Snapper Island, the guys had to catch fish, not just for fun, but for survival. After weeks on the island with no sign of being rescued, tension was building between the trio of friends.
Acting like he's the man. I thought we were a team.
I asked Matty if I could use one of his traces that he made up earlier. And he said no. He's not been a team player at the moment.
With winter now upon them, the castaways would have to work harder to catch snapper. But winter is also the time when the big snapper move into the kelp beds of Snapper Island. The question is, would they have the patience and skill to catch one of the resident big snapper? And would the stranded survivors be rescued? Find out in this week's exciting finale of Castaway Survivors, Snapper Island.
Hey man, a boat! A boat! Hey! Hey! Yo!
Oh, too bad. The fishing's still good.
It's cowboy, there's so many of them in the belly trails that are baked down through them. Once again, real dark, dark resident fish. Really dark. Now, because this fish was hooked deep, it's well legal, we're entitled to keep it, but I've pulled the hook out and I'm just going to release him in this rock pool. Now, if he's still swimming around in a couple of minutes' time, I'll scoop him out and let him go into the ocean. But if he dies, of course, we can take him back and eat him. There he goes. He seems okay thus far. Nice steep rock pool. It's like having our own little aquarium here.
Yeah, something's picked that up, mate. Something's having a go. Take it.
Oh, yes. We're in, boys, we're in.
I can feel him around the rock, so I'm glad I speeded it up a bit in that last one. Oh, here he comes. That's better.
Yeah.
He's a beauty. Good Nick. Put up a good fight.
Well, like that says what?
23.1 pound.
Okay, mate, let her rip. Nice fish, mate. We had to earn it. There it goes. There it goes. Look at it. Look, it's just cruising away, happy as. Well done, brother.
Shut up, mate. That's what we come for.
The fishing had improved, and the big snapper that Brandon caught had really lifted morale on Snapper Island. With plenty of fresh snapper for food, catching a big snapper now became the main focus for the survivors. After overcoming their differences, competition for the biggest snapper now threatened to tear apart the three friends, as all three survivors were determined to be the first to catch a 20-pound snapper.
Oh man, he's got in under this weed here. It's a good one, man, but he's under the rock. Here we go, sort of just casting back into this gut. Great big kawai head on for bait. And the snapper's just been stooging down here. Nice fish, man, here. Woohoo! Cheers, bro! You see this fish here? When you look at his teeth, you know he's been living in around the rocks, eating mussels and kinner and stuff, because these teeth here are completely worn down round.
I want to be very careful putting my finger in there because that jaw crushes up muscles and it'll crush up my finger, no worries too. Just going to pop that hook out the corner of his mouth. Oh, nicely, okay, he's ready to go back. Nice fish. Yes. Well, you know, it's really not all that bad being stuck out here on this rock. I've got my mates for company, we're keeping each other amused, catching plenty of fish, we're eating well. And we've got this gutter here that's got all these washing rocks and snapper moving up into it, and we've pulled a few real beauts out of here. I mean, I could quite happily fish my whole life in an area like this. But, you know, eventually we'll get picked up, but in the meantime we're having a hell of a time. Oh, hello, here we go. Oh, yes!
Yeah! Oh, my
Nice fish, Matty!
Snapper for tea tonight again, boys!
Shot, brother!
Sweet! Beautiful specimen here. He came out of this gutter that we've been fishing for a little while now, and I reckon we should try another spot, eh? We've pulled a few fish out of this gutter. We'd normally let a fish like this go, but yeah, we're getting pretty hungry. You know, we've been scratching around to get bait. So yeah, this will feed us for a couple of days. We're going to try another spot, eh, boys?
Well, it has been 2 years.
You think someone's going to find us?
Well, I hope not. Now, we've well and truly run out of burley now. But because there's been so much swell for the last 3 or 4 days, the waves breaking on the rocks all around this area has created a natural burley slick by smashing up all the kinner and crustaceans. And rather than having burley to bring fish to me, I'm just going to move around today and cast into these gutters around the kelp to try and catch a big snapper. Yo! Try and work him out. Keep him moving. I can see him down there. It's just my lines run right through this weed. There is, he's a nice snapper. Here he comes, you can see him just, oh, broke the surface then. I've just got to keep his head up and out of that weed. I've really given this fish bugger all to work with, and because I'm here on my own now, I'm not going to be able to land this fish. I'm just going to have to use the swell. Just slowly wash him up onto the rocks. There he goes. Get down there and grab him by the trace. Woohoo! Now that's the sort of big snapper that we come here for. Probably won't give Brina's big one a real run for its money, but just looking at that, I mean, I'd really love to let these bigger breeding fish go, but you can see a bit of blood coming out of the gills. It's obviously had an injury there, but I can assure you it won't go to waste. Still a beautiful, big, fat, good condition snapper to eat. Well, there you go. I'm just gonna give him a bit of a spike with a knife in the brain there, and that there is a nice snapper off the rocks in anyone's language. Probably around the 10-pound mark, and that's probably gonna keep us fed for a good little while now. All I've gotta do is just persevere for that really big one. Lots and lots of these smaller fish, albeit very good eating size fish, sort of 35 to 40 centimeter fish, but of course, they're not the ones we're after. I've had a couple of really nice takes from bigger fish, but I just don't think that using the smaller yellow-eyed mullet is the key here. I've got to use a really big bait to try and dissuade the little ones from eating it. You can just see there that this sprat's just been nibbled away around the hook. So I'm gonna have to go to a whole skipjack tuna head. That'll slow the little ones down, but that's just a lollipop for a big snapper. Okay, now something has eaten this tuna head. It's just been slowly swimming away with it. I've only got it just hooked through the nose, so I really got to give him plenty of time to eat it. There he goes, come on, eat it. Oh, he let it go, come on! He's come back, he's got it. Yes! Holy heck! Trav, this is the big one, mate! This is the one! I've just got to hold on to it. I've just got to somehow hold on to this fish. Come
I mean, it's got to be a good fish to have eaten that tuna head for a start. Oh, there he is. Look, I've got him right up away from the weed. I'm in a good position now. I've got colour there. Nice big kelp colours on him. Look at him glinting in the sun. Oh, look at him. You beauty. Now, I've got to be real careful here. Just got to keep it. Oh, he's going for cover in that gut. Okay, now you can see I'm just using the rod to lift him up. Here he is. Just washing the way his head goes. I've got to roll him over. Oh, geez. He swallowed that really deep, so that hook, that trace will be rubbing. It's a nice snapper, boy, I tell you. It's a really nice one. It's got to keep tension on. Grab the trace. Oh, shit, broken. I got him. I got him. I lost me rod in the water, but I got me fish. There was no wires there in that, bummer guy. Look at that. Got me fish and me rod. He broke the line as I was trying to bring him up there. And you look at him, he's got this huge lump, like a giant abscess or something there. Obviously from an old injury or something. He's a real battler, and if he can survive that, he's good breeding stock. He's got to go 20 pounds, and I'm going to let him go. Well, you'll notice the line didn't actually break. The hook actually pulled out. Oh, made my day. Away you go, mate. There he goes. Look at him, down in the kelp. Yes!
By now, the survivors had given up all hope of rescue. But they had reached a point where they were enjoying each other's company and were happy in the knowledge that they could go fishing every day for the rest of their lives. The only question was, would they have enough tackle?
Oh, he's gone to ground. He's in the reef. It's my last hook. I don't want to lose my last hook.
Don't lose them, mate. It's our last hook.
Don't lose that hook.
I got him, boys. I got him.
Work him out.
Oh. Oh, no!
Squid, who's on dinner tonight?
Matty, what's for dinner?
Snap it for tea tonight, boys. G'day and welcome to the first and last instalment of Matt's Natural Outdoor Wild Food Organic Kitchen. Today we've got some beautiful fresh produce, namely the big snapper that we just caught, and I've sliced just a nice chunk off the bottom of the fillet. Fortunately, we've had a bit of tinfoil wash up on the beach, and what we do, and if ever you're in an outdoor environment and you don't have access to a kitchen, a bit of tinfoil and an open fire does an awesome job of cooking fish. We're just going to place our bit of fish, fresh snapper, in the middle of a bit of tinfoil here. Fortunately, the only tree on the island is a lemon tree, and we're just going to take a bit of lemon, just a squeeze of lemon, and a bit of fish. That's all. Nothing complicated about our cooking here on the island. And we just fold that into a nice wee parcel. And just as you fold it up, make sure that the joins stay at the top so you don't get any ash. Get into your nice little parcel. Now, I've just had this fire that I've built here. I'm just going to pop this little parcel just neatly into the ash there, and that's going to just cook away, and that fish will actually cook in that lemon juice and its own juices. That's been on there for probably 5 or so minutes now. You've got to be a little bit careful because of course it's hot, and we're just going to open up our little parcel, and you can see there we've got these beautiful flakes of fresh snapper that just flakes away. You know that that's perfectly cooked. It hasn't dried out at all. Oh yeah, beautiful. Dinner's ready, boys! Hello? Matt Watson? No, sorry. No one by Matt Watson here, mate. Wrong number, I think. I'm just getting a few little takes now. It's quite a big bait, I'm just going to feed him out a little bit of line to see if he... A boat! Hey!
Hey, look, there's some guys on the rocks over here.
Hey,
huh.
Man, we didn't expect to find you guys alive.
Hey, have you got some spare hooks for us? We need some spare hooks.
Bro, can you tell my missus I'm going to be late?
Oh, you guys are hard men.
Sweet as, you got some hooks for us?
Yeah, mate.
Sure.
Now, here's a rare little insight into how we make the show. The beard and shaggy hair that I grew over the course of the years stuck on Snapper Island, it was in fact not real. Look, I know. Our makeup and wardrobe department did such a good job, but we thought this was the perfect opportunity 7 or 8 years on to reveal that in fact we weren't actually stranded on an island.